Given the function f of x equals negative 2 square root x plus 7, we want to determine the given function values. So to evaluate f of 0, notice how we've replaced x with 0 here. So to determine the function value, we'll substitute 0 for x here and then evaluate. So we'd have negative 2 times square root 0 plus 7. Well, the square root of 0 is 0, so we'd have negative 2 times 0 plus 7, which is equal to 7. So f of 0 equals 7, which means for this function, when the input is 0, the output is positive 7. But graphically, this means that when the x-coordinate is 0, the y-coordinate would be 7, and therefore this would be a point on the graph of the given function. For f of 1, we'll now substitute 1 for x. So f of 1 is going to be equal to negative 2 times the square root of 1 plus 7. Well, the square root of 1 is equal to 1, so we have negative 2 times 1 plus 7. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2 plus 7 is equal to 5. So here f of 1 is equal to 5. So when the input is 1, the function value is 5. Graphically, this represents the point with an x-coordinate of 1 and a y-coordinate of 5. So this point would be on the graph of the function. And let's go ahead and try one more. Here we have f of 36, so now we'll substitute 36 for x. So we'll have negative 2 times the square root of 36 plus 7. The square root of 36 is 6, so this would be negative 2 times 6 plus 7. Negative 2 times 6 is negative 12. Negative 12 plus 7 is equal to negative 5. So here we have a function value of negative 5, or f of 36 is equal to negative 5. So when the x-coordinate is 36, the y-coordinate would be negative 5. And this would be another point on the graph of the function. Let's go ahead and quickly check these function values on the calculator. If we press y equals, clear this old equation, we can type in our function and then use a table feature to check our function values. So we'll have negative 2 second x squared brings up the square root. Then we have square root of x plus 7. Now if we go to the table set by pressing second window, notice how I've changed the independent variable to ask. If ask is not highlighted, we just need to go down to this row, highlight ask, and press enter. And now when we go to the table feature by pressing second graph, we can type in any x value that we want. So if we type in x equals 0, x equals 1, and x equals 36, we can check our function values in the y column. Notice we have 7, 5, and negative 5, which verifies we did this correctly. And if we want to look at the graph of the function, we can just press graph. This way we can make the connection that f of 0 equals 7 represents a point on the function that would be this point right here with an x-coordinate of 0 and a y-coordinate of 7. F of 1 equals 5 would be the point here on the function. And then f of 36 equals negative 5 would be this point here, but it is off the screen. I hope you found this helpful.